Welcome back to the second day of the John Wick's Invitational. This time I got it right. You're with Valor and Cadian, as we'll be casting the second semi-final of this evening. Denial beat SKDC 2-0 earlier on. And now it will be Savage versus MouseSpaz, formerly known as Netcode Guides. Netcode Guides, or MouseSpaz, the favorites coming into this tournament and the favorites to win this tournament, as they're on paper the third best team. Them and Denial only had one match between them and iBuyPower, and they could have actually gone on to the Face It LAN Finals that will be starting tomorrow in the Milan Games Week. So two top sides Denial has gone through, and it seems most likely that MouseSpaz will probably get the better off Savage in this best of three. But Savage, they do have potential. They've been up and rising. They've improved quite a bit in recent weeks coming up to this tournament, and we do expect them to perhaps.
They already knocked out one invited team for this tournament.
And a good team as well. Area 51 were expected to beat Savage, as Savage qualified and Area 51 were invited. So it was a bit of an upset that Area 51 lost against Savage. So perhaps they might make a second upset against MouseSpaz, formerly Netcode Guides. We will be playing a best of three. It's Mirage, then Nuke, and if needed, it'll be Inferno. But for your information, MouseSpaz decided on Mirage. They got the choice, and Savage were the team that decided to play on Nuke. So if this is the stronger map for MouseSpaz, if it's their choice, then perhaps we expect them to win this game. They start off on the CT side. Actually, Savage start off CT side, mind my English. And CT side is the stronger side on Mirage, isn't it, Circadian?
Yeah, it could be. It could be. Not always, but it depends. I think that you have the opportunities to go for a lot of map control as CT and Mirage, especially during the pushes into the holes can be very effective. So you see the mid control being a big possibility for the pistol round off the terror side here. They're most likely going to do a split B. You can see that on the composition of the map. You have two guys going towards B holes and you have two guys going towards mid, and Hades is going to get them in the gap here. It's actually a fail smoke towards this CPL area here.
Yeah, he's done a very nice job. Two frags for Hades already, and that's a good start here. Savage now have the two-man advantage. They do have control of both sites, although quite a deep position from the man over on the B site, which is Valens. But the terrorists seem to be going to a fake towards A and having the bomb go towards the B site, or maybe it's going through tunnels. Hades actually flashed in through. Great job here as he gets a double kill on Glorence and Hades. Hazed, sorry. They have very similar names.
Yeah.
Caster's Nightmare. But Valens with that backstab on Hazed to take him down. And, well, Taric, they made enough noise on the A site, and they've allowed him to get the bomb plant, so they
shouldn't push alone the CT, and he's also going to reconsider that situation, and he's going to go for the first.
Oh, Taric, my lord! Two kills here for Taric. Can he make it three? This would be huge! 1v3 clutch here by Taric, and he's on low HP. Taric has more. Taric's run out of ammo. He's going to definitely have to land. Oh, my lord, he's on burst fire, and he's missed both, but he gets the final shot regardless, as Cud was unable to finish off Taric. Beautiful play by this young star, and he's definitely a player to look out for, Taric, isn't he?
He is, but we have to admit that as beautiful the first two kills was from Taric, just as weird was the last one, because he missed around 15 bullets on the guy with 10 HP.
Yeah, and Cud missed quite a few as well.
But yeah. He'll take that, right?
Oh yeah, definitely.
So yeah, 1-0 for MouseSpaz. Hades coming in with a very great beginning here, using the gap in the smoke in the window to just get two easy kills without the terrorists really noticing. And then this drag back in rushing into the window room by the terrorists, getting two kills, was just, that was the whole, yeah, I don't know, it was at least the most important thing about the strat, because I don't think that was the plan from the beginning, but it completely saved them. And here comes the anti-eco on the B side.
Very, very nice strat coming in from the T side, as you mentioned, and now they do have the control of the B site. Relics causing a bit of damage by getting one kill with the CZ, but on this forced buy, well, this forced buy has been relatively unsubstantial and might make a bit of economic damage, I think, the CT side. Hades taking down Hazed.
Kind of questionable. had two bullets left, so it was kind of worth reloading there. But he should just get away here, and he's going to get away with his Kevlar and his CZ. Going to be very useful in the next round. Oh. And they did economical damage, and they're going to get one more here. The guy pushing short should be taken down by the CT, and he is going to be doomed.
Yeah.
So a three-man trade for both teams here.
It's interesting. Actually, AK-47 picked up here by Glorin, so very nicely done on Eco. But it was interesting that Glorin was going for the save while Hage was pushing.
Yeah. Well, so what you would like to do in a situation like that as a terrorist is that you want to be saving your weapons together. So in case one of your teammates is going to die, you can at least get the revenge kill so that the opponent is not going to be able to pick up the weapon. So kind of questionable to go for the save alone. How did he get away
three
with that?
Three nades and he Matrix.
Matrix.
Some crazy Matrix stuff happening there. I don't know how he got away from that, but three nades pretty much almost at the same time thrown towards his direction, and he survived with 9 HP. Alex is still alive. They do have AK-47 the CT side, and the terrorists are going towards the B site. There's one CT in the deep. They've smoked off A site, and they will be able to take down Kanu's over on connector as the CT is now coming for the rotation over on towards Kitchen. Hazed with a double kill going into the B site. Tarik.
He's going to be looking to
quick double as well.
I was just going to say save the AK, but he's going to try and go huge with the play here and go for a 3 or 4K, but he's not going to get that with the AK. Should probably just have been running away from that situation, because it could be like a big relief for the economy to save an AK and maybe could grab an M4 for someone so he would be able to buy fully up with nades and kit and everything.
Yep.
But he tried to go for the play, it didn't work this time, can't blame him.
Yeah, 3-0 here as MouseSpaz have done a good job making sure that they don't lose to that fourth spy. Tarik is on 7 kills and 1 death. Definitely a player to watch out for indeed. And this tournament has performed very, very well so far. Savage, however, now able to go for a full bite for the first time in this game. And we'll really see if they're able to hold off against the very, very strong T side with full bite. I mean, they've had a close first round. They've done some economical damage. Hades, oh, he just misses that shot. That forces him to move position, and at least he does. That nade following him once more. And they've been throwing some good nades here at the T side.
Yeah. And Hade is once again finding a pretty decent angle. That's going to connect the first time and cut with the spray down to Aabs.
Tarik trying to be a hero there, going Rambo style from Palace. It didn't work out for him. FNS has control of connector. Can cut the CT team in half if he's able to push through, perhaps go towards window. But it's actually quite a deep position by the player who's at window, or CPL, as he gives away that position. Cutler is there, and Terrorist slowly, step by step, get map control. CT's though staying alive.
That's an important kill. It's going to be 2-2 split on the CTs, and they're going to be caught here in the middle of everything.
Oh, nicely done by Relix. He gets the first strike, we get the second. Glorin's there. Nice crossfire set up here as the bomb goes down. And Glorin's going to pop out and end the round and get Savage the first round of this match on their first buy round as well. Not badly done by them. Good A site defense and well defended. They were shot down. They didn't stay. They didn't kind of play aggressive. They didn't go for it. They backed away. They gave away the positions on the map, and they just waited until they kind of put the terrorists where they wanted them, and they were able to make some good exchanges and come out the better.
Yeah, and now comes the all or nothing round here from the CTs. In case they lose this one, they're gonna be money broke, and you can see MouseSpaz going for a set strategy here. So maybe it's one of the best strategies. Normally you do that in the situations where you can money fuck the other team.
Yep.
It's the right description to say, because if they win this one, they're going to set Savage to a double eco. And a double eco on the CT side is just a massive disaster to be receiving.
Yes, definitely. It would mean 6 rounds for MouseSpaz. 6-1 is not a real great round, a great score to have early on this map. But they are going towards the B site as flashes go down. Balance is in the right position to kind of deflect those flashes. The Molotov will come down, but it doesn't do quite a lot of damage. Tarik actually receives a bit from Balance, but a quick double kill from him. He is absolutely on fire. Very, very fast. Nade follows him, but he's got 3 HP. Still survives. Relic coming in to support. Should be an easy kill for him on Tarik. Gets one down. It's 3-on-4 as they push into the site. There is a smoke off over on Shot, and JDM, who's a very, very good offer indeed, is aiming. Oh, Lord. He misses a pretty standard shot indeed. Now the CTs are still alive. Could be the first mistake, as now the CTs are pushing into the side. Not a lot of HP between them. Both of the Ts are in the corner here as JDM goes down to Cud. And now it's all up to Haze. The bomb's going to explode very, very soon. There is going to be defuse kit. This could be huge by Haze if he stops them from planting the bomb. That's all he has to do. There's not a lot of time left. Gets the second kill. We'll get the third. Beautiful 1v3. Haze, you have done an excellent job indeed as he makes it 4-1. Savage could have... should have won that round.
Yeah, in theory they shouldn't, because that double entry by Tarik was just massive, so he's really been important in these early stages of this game, because he got the 1-on-3 in the pistol round, and in this situation about money destroying the Savage team, he gets a double entry onto the B-bomb side. But you said it yourself, a pretty crucial miss by JDM with the AWP and nearly cost him that round.
Yeah, the... Still, Tarik did enough damage, and the rest of the team did enough damage to kind of weaken the CTs as they tried to go for that retake, and that allowed Haze to get the quick triple at the end and win that clutch. Nicely done by FNS to take down Relics, and inside Relics trying to land some CZ shots, but it's just too far, and the aim punch as well really destroyed his aim.
Exactly. A nice kill by FNS here. And basically in these anti-eco rounds, I actually have to give MouseSpaz some credit, because they have been playing fast, they haven't been scared, but it hasn't been stupid moves either. The CTs is slightly aggressive, and maybe a bit too much for my taste, because if you want to win these rounds, you simply need to try and gather information, and then go for the right stack on the bump side later on in the round. But since they give away easy kills in the beginning every time when the terrorists try to initiate a push, they're always going to be a man down, and a man down with worse equipment than your opponent is just going to be extremely hard to come back from.
Yep, definitely. And this again, you said it before. They would be what was the word? The economy.
Oh, money fuck. Oh, what?
I'll let you say the swear word. But
you wanted me. You're baiting me too, dude.
Yeah, I'm baiting you. I'm trolling Cadian live on stream.
I don't even realize it.
Yeah, you don't realize it because I'm a clever troll. But another eco round. Glorin's has some armor, but it should be another round for MouseSpaz to make it 6-1. Oh, Lord. Beautiful triple kill by Glorin's over towards Palace. That's ridiculous. And, you know, that happens once. A full moon, I think. Absolutely beautiful.
But they could throw this one. Wait for it. Everything is going to be an FNZ FNS here.
And he gives away his position. Glorin's gets a 4K. Could be an ace on... Oh, my Lord. If he gets an ace on an eco, you don't normally see a lot of that. Ace on an eco round. He can get the kill on FNS. He has the AK-47. Relics. He can bait him. Glorin's can get the kill. I mean, the bomb's down. Just take it easy. 35 seconds left on the clock. FNS, he's a smart player. He's already got 2 kills. He's taking it easy. He's going to push through connector. Could be an ace here for Glorin's, and it would be a huge one. He's right in front of him. Oh, no. He just goes to the right, and he steals it. He's going to be mad.
What
steal. Bad boy, Relics. Very, very bad.
Downvote him, someone. Kick him.
Guys, make a thread on HLTV about Relics. But a beautiful triple kill this season. And that shows, you know, in a short distance how powerful it is.
I didn't even see 3 kills, I saw 2.
Yeah, it was a wall bang. The final bullet, I think it was the final bullet in his CZ, just caught the last player as he tried to back away in Palace. Through the corner of the wall. It was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. 5-2, as Savage win a very, very nice eco round. And that's really good, especially since they were so badly hurt by the economy and they lost the first eco round to get the second and make it 5-2 and keep them in the game. Cut with a frag on FNS. But
a good trade for the terrorists.
Oh, yeah, 1-for-1 trade.
Yeah.
Again, it's always a good trade. But it was a bit of luck, you could say.
Yeah,
well.
Exactly.
I mean, you can't really rely on Glorin to get a triple kill to see that on Palace every single round, can you?
And they got the control of this CPL room here, and Cutler's gonna flash out in JDM as well. The counter-terrorist on short is gonna have a very essential position. If he dies, the round is gonna be lost, but he could get a double kill as well.
Yeah, again, pretty deep position by Hades. He's been doing that quite a long, as the way CPL backs away. Molotov won't do much. They know that he's there because he threw the Molotov, so it should be an easy kill for Cutler as he dispatches of him. And wow, not bad at all by Glorin's. 2 kills, drops the bomb, Hades there in support. Now it's all up to Hazed, the counterpart of Hades, as he's now in a 2-on-1 situation with the bomb down, 30 seconds left on the clock. They have to play it nice and clever here, the CTs. They do back away. Glorin's goes towards apartments, just in case. But they do see the Molotov thrown by the terrorist. They know he's probably coming in from short, but now that it's taken a while, Hazed is doing a sneaky beaky movement through towards kitchen to come up from behind. And I don't think any of them expect that. I think Hazed is looking towards kitchen here.
Yeah, he's low on HP, Hazed, so it's going to be a difficult task, and time is running out.
No, he won't be able to get the bomb plant, but he'll try and save the M4, which he'll do. He'll save that M4 at least for MouseSpaz. Hades, yes, there's the Greek god.
Yeah.
I blame you, Cadian.
You blame me?
Yes, for calling him Hades. 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 Hades sounds right. Now it makes sense. Now we don't have to say two words that are almost the same, and we actually can name him by his real name.
Actually, a big big difference in the pronunciation of those two names.
Who is that on his display pic?
It's not Hades, for sure.
I don't think Hades looks like that.
No.
He doesn't wear
glasses,
does he?
It depends if you watched Hercules or whatever it's called.
Yeah, I don't think the Greeks drew Hades with glasses.
Lawrence, oh, the Molotov here, two wars connected, is going to force a different push.
Oh, really, really nicely done by Lawrence. Good, good bit of game sense by him to hold that position and use the protection that the guy's pushing.
The
bomb's down! Big mistake by Tarek, who loses the bomb in CPL. And now Hades can come into support with that finesse. Well, they've done actually quite a bit of damage so far, bearing in mind it is an eco. Three kills on an eco round. It's not bad at all by MouseSpaz. But 5-4. Savage now, reducing the distance between them and MouseSpaz, as they've won a few rounds in a row now. MouseSpaz are still unable to go for a full buy. They've gone for armor on Cutler, and Tarek CZ's around. And it looks like it might be a fast A push here.
Exactly. And they invested a little in this round. They had the possibility of going for the AK buy with the one guy having pistols, but they decided to go for some CZ Kevlar, so they are sure that they're going to be able to buy in the next round as well. Very interesting to see how this round is going to work out.
Nice small one there by Lorenz, and Tarek is going to get that entry frag. Good smokes by the T's as well. He's able to plant the bomb. That's the job done here. He's actually gotten frag on Relics. Falens will take down JDM, however. Tarek picks up the M4 that Relics had. And he's in a really, really big position here. And we get a frag. Oh, Lorenz from behind will stop him from killing Hades, actually protecting the life of his teammates. And they will get the bomb defused. But a bomb plant there.
Yeah, it was worth it. And they actually had the possibility of winning the round. The big mistake from the Terriers, or at least the problem with that round, was that they didn't have any control. They had a bad bomb plant, which they couldn't see from the slow barrier. And when you don't have a good bomb plant for the slow barrier, you need to have control over either jungle or CT spawn. And since they had control over none of those positions, they were just caught up in the slow barrier, having to take the aim belts long distance with the CZ, and that wasn't in a favorable position for them.
It's nice to see that Savage are kind of changing up the way they take control of mid, rather than just going to CPL every single round. Hades actually going towards B short, although it is a longer way to go to mid, but it still allows them to get the information if they push towards mid. And there is a three-man stack towards the A site here. The Terrorists deciding that perhaps it's not the best idea to push into the site. They don't have good enough information to make that decision. And now that the CTs are creeping up towards mid, they know for sure they're going towards the A site, and there could be a flank coming in from the CTs. But it's, I think it's better if Hades just relaxes in that position rather than pushing
positions.
And perhaps losing the AWP.
They're not going to clear out the third guy. The third guy is just very important that he doesn't show himself too early. That could very well be cut.
It's a bomb site in execute here coming in from MouseSpaz. For the pre-fire, but nobody's there. Spud moves in just at the last moment. He gets a quick double kill on JDM and Cutler. FNS though will take him down regardless. Relics takes down FNS in return. Tarek just under the ladder. Oh, he gets blocked. It's a 1-2 though. He's got 3 HP, and he backs away.
Yeah.
Makes the angle nice and narrow.
Yeah. He's very low. Oh, he's going to get the first.
He's won a 1v3. It's 10 seconds left on the clock. Valens should just be backing away. But, oh, he actually makes it to the bomb. He throws down a smoke, thinking that he's going to come in. And it was a bit of a fake plant. Still not fast enough. And Valens will get that frag and make it 65 for Savage. Tarek almost getting the round for MouseSpaz, but not good enough.
Yeah, exactly. was a pretty good try by Tarik though. That headshot on the second guy was pretty amazing. And once again, Cuddler is gonna smoke off the window area. They're gonna go for some mid control. Most likely also gonna flash for his teammate. And yeah, pulling out the flash, flashing out the orb. It's gonna go out in the middle. It's JDM together with FNS taking control of the middle area.
And the A site push didn't work for them. They didn't get a round win from it, but they were able to get quite close to that. They do have complete and utter mid control. They've left the bomb back towards T spawn and decided which site they'll be going to. But it should be a B split coming in from the terrorists. They got one frag on relics.
Yeah, it was a pretty good push in the beginning by Hades, though. Going into the A-Apps, A-Palace, with the AWP, is using the distance in a new position where the rifles of the terrorists are don't always expect it. So he got a fairly easy kill and rotated back without being without the terrorists having any chance of trading.
Well, that fake by the teasers actually forced the CTs to rotate and give away the A-site positions, and now they're quite deep in. Valens takes down Cutler, quite an important kill over and towards mid, but he'll be shot down by JDM. Nicely done by Cut to take down FNS and make it a 2-on-1 situation. JDM now with the AWP and the bomb down has to try and contest both CTs. They just have to play it nice and clever. There's 25 seconds left on the clock. The CTs have to set up a crossfire and move in together at the same time. They know he's got an AWP. He hasn't picked up a rifle yet. And he'll just go for the bomb. Actually, it's a fake plan.
Oh, he shouldn't have went out of the plan.
He should have got the plan, should have got the money, but he makes the frag on Cut. I don't know what Glor is doing. He should have pushed in at the same time, or at least supported his teammate, but he makes it a 1-on-1, and he will win that 1-on-1, and he's been playing very well indeed, actually. And I think that 4K that he got that round really kind of boosted him a bit, and he started to really land some nice shots.
He was also doing very nice aiming in the B in one of the rounds, so he's just he's been showing to have some great individual skill.
Yeah, 13 kills on him. He's top fragging for his side right now. And Savage are actually doing a good job against MouseSpaz, especially since they started off pretty badly on a weak foot and were quite a few rounds behind on what I think would be a relatively CT-sided map, especially when you play it mixed style.
Yeah, right? Exactly. Yeah.
But some good T strategies can make this more of a T-sided map. And Savage now on their way to winning perhaps more rounds than MouseSpaz in the first half, if they're able to get this round here. But there is a full buy coming in from MouseSpaz. As again, they go for mid control and they get it.
Yeah. MouseSpaz has been doing a lot of things correct theoretically, but it just hasn't worked out. And the guy behind him with the AWP sitting there behind the smoke is Hades, and he's gonna get another kill with the AWP.
And he's giving them a one-way ticket to hell there with his AWP.
He's been pretty good with this window area, just using the smokes for his advantage.
Ooh, that flick shot.
Oh, this he sees
his gun. Easy kill for JDM. 4v2 here as Cud takes down FNS. Hayes gets yet another kill on towards the A site. Won't be able to make it 3 as Glorins will take him down. Actually make it 2. Hayes only got 1 frag. JDM now picking up the AWP. Finished off by Glorins, who gets himself 2 kills that round. 8-5 here. Savage now with more rounds than MouseSpaz in the first half. But can they increase their lead even further?
8-5. MouseSpaz has been in quite a big struggle since their achievement of getting the 5th round. They have been having a lot of trouble. I would like to see them going back to maybe the B execute, where they got that 4th round, with the Tarik getting the double entry. Which seems to work pretty good.
I think right now the B side is really the weakness for Savage, but it doesn't seem like MouseSpaz has figured that out. You have Hades and Glorins over towards the A side, and they've been doing a very excellent job getting the frags and picking up the frags. But there's actually a switch of players. Relics this time is now on the A side, and Valens is towards the B side. So they've been kind of switching around both. But every round, Glorins has been on the A side. Hades has been around towards mid. But Valens just missing those few shots on the FNS. Clean up, however, as Savage are playing a very, very dominant CT side here. 9-5, they can make it 10-5. There's not a lot of money in MouseSpaz's bank, so it will be a motley purchase by them here. Hazed, only 3.8k to his name. On the other hand, full buy from the CTs. 4 Galils and an AK on JDM, but no armor. He opts to buy flashes in his front instead. But MouseSpaz with 5 rounds, can they...
Yeah, they can still win.
They can still win.
Yeah. for sure. I think a lot of these American teams so far, without being generalizing every team, it seems that all American teams have some troubles on the T side, but has a very strong team. This time, two guys towards A3. Oh, the rotation coming in here by there the CTs go. Is massive. This fake could work.
Well, there is one CT left in towards the A site. That is Glorin's, the stronger player. Hades will get that frag on FNS, so now it's a 4-on-4 situation. Valens was shot down. They push him inside. It's actually quite late, and oh, Tarik with a headshot on Glorin's. That makes it a 2v4 situation. It could be a run for MouseSpaz. Could be 96 coming into the second half.
Yes. 4-2 situation for the terrorist. And Haste with the backstab.
He is actually picking up the M4 instead of the AWP. Gets one frag. So it seems like MouseSpaz steal around from Savage to make it 9-6 in the first half. Nicely done by Savage to come back after losing so many rounds earlier on in the game. And it seemed like they lost complete control of the match, but they were able to kind of come back and do a relatively good job indeed.
Yeah. I'm a bit disappointed by MouseSpaz T-side, because they had a very good beginning getting the pistol round, which already there was kind of lucky by Tarek's 1-on-3 clutch. Not only that, the only reason which you actually got two more rounds was because of the money system, where they totally took away the money from the CT side. Of course, that is clever play, but other than those rounds, they didn't really show any teeth, I think.
Yeah, I mean, excellent play from Tarek,
yeah, but
as
good
well.
Fake in the end.
Yeah, it was nice. We need to see that.
That's the first time tonight that we see a proper fake by the American teams. So good to see that.
I mean, one thing that we've noticed with all the teams on the CT side is that they're very fast with the rotation, yeah. And you can exploit that by going with a fake. And when you watch European matches, they're very, very, very static with the way they position their players. I mean, you always see, even if they like people on the B site on Inferno see people coming in, you don't see all the players from the A site going towards the B site. Or on other maps, you don't see all the players going in for the rotation. In fact, they wait until they're 100% sure that, okay, three or four players have pushed into the site, then they go for the rotation after that. But so far, we've seen them have some really, really fast rotations. And finally, a team's actually taken advantage of that.
Exactly. So what do you expect from the second half?
It seems like MouseSpaz are finally into it. They won that round at the end. And on the CT side, unless Savage do have some tricks under their sleeves, I think MouseSpaz will be able to regain control of the match and win it. But it will be close, I believe. I think it's going to be a close match.
Yeah, I'm going to call 16-12 for MouseSpaz in this first map.
I was going to say that, but just to be different to you, I'll say 16-13. Okay. So that if it's above 13, I win. If it's below 12, you win.
And in case that MouseSpaz loses, I will also win, okay?
Why is that?
Just because I need to win.
Nope, that's not fair.
You're not
we both
satisfied.
Lose. No, we both lose.
Yeah, because that's both a fair deal.
Yeah, it is a fair deal.
We can be losers together on the stream.
Yes, Cadian, yes, we can. We can both
be
the losers.
Oh, but yeah, you guys watching the stream, tell us, who do you think is going to win? And if you placed a bet, who did you bet on?
And also tell us how silly Cadian's hat is. If you think it looks...
Oh, it's nice.
If you think it looks nice, tell us it looks nice. If you think it looks silly, say it looks silly. Oh, he's gone for the hat twist. And I saw it through the camera instead of looking to my left. But yeah, showing off his team colors.
It's pretty nice, guys.
And by the way, he's wearing my shirt, just to mention it. You know, swag sponsored by Avela.
Listen, I'm getting told by the guys that my shirt is too fancy.
It's too fancy?
No, my other shirts, you know, the ones...
Oh, they're not too fancy, they're just weird. He's got a shirt with polka dots, and then he's got like one of those beach Hawaii shirts, and he wants to cast face at LAN finals with a Hawaii shirt. I don't know.
It's a good vacation to be on. The weather here in Milan is way better than it is in Denmark. So.
Yeah, but your mic's fallen down, just in case. You're too busy adjusting your hat swag that you forgot that you dropped your mic. But still, I think simple, nice, elegant shirt is always better than polka dots.
What was the name of the bird?
The puffin.
Puffin.
So you're a puffin.
Yeah, it is. You guys know it's all about doing the puffin trick. Yeah. Getting those crazy shirts, getting the attention from the ladies, the puffin shirt.
If you have something to, you know, if you feel like you're missing something and you have to kind of you have to be extravagant to and look, Look, Cadian's just reading people's messages.
Yeah, I have the biggest smile on my face. Cadian looking good, you know? God damn it. Love you guys out there.
Nice, Cadian. Grill commentators. Why do you need grill commentators when we have so much swag? But
anyways, the pissed round is on its way, Avela, and we are not even casting it. What's going on here? It's going to be a fake towards the B-bomb side, and they're going to rotate back to A. But it seems that MouseSpaz is going to remain their positions. And the push up through smoke with no grenades is going to be a truly disaster, I believe, for the Terrace. But they're actually going to get the first kill here.
Well, Valance wants the Frank and Haze. But not the second on JDM as he takes down Hades. Actually, he took down Hades, didn't he?
Is this really going to work?
What is happening here? Frag's going all over the place, but Tarek will finish it off for MouseSpaz and make it 9-7. What happened?
You analyzed that round for me.
I have no idea what happened. I really, really don't know what they did wrong. I mean, they just pushed into the site and then going for the bomb plant and...
It was something like running B, one of their teammates dies, they run the long way back. So the CTs are still in position, they run out without any flashbangs, smoke grenades whatsoever. And still they actually managed to get it to a fairly close round.
So they've landed their shots at least. Not the best of CT rounds by MouseSpaz, but they get it regardless. They make it 1-0, which is 9-7 overall. So only two rounds away.
And the MP9, I believe it's called by Haste. Kind of rare to see that, but it's going to be the retake setup on the A-bomb side. Haste is going to go up with the MP9. He's going to get the first, going to look for the second.
Oh, the MP9 King gets two frags for being finally put down by Glorians. USP.
And it's not to be this stupid Danish guy just criticizing, but in these eco rounds, I always think you need to go for a goal, which is either you do economical damage or you gain economical money yourself, okay? So that means basically either you go to try and do a rush where it's all or nothing, where you take down members from the opponent, so they need to rebuy rifles in the next round, which means that you have an easier way of forcing them to eco rounds later on in the game. Or you go to try and gain up more money by your own side by going for strategies where you go for the bomb plant.
Yep.
And in this situation, Savage went for nothing of those. So they actually just got one weapon down and didn't even have a slight opportunity of going for the bomb plant. So no. It was just a lose-lose situation.
Yeah. 9-8 now for MouseSpaz. They're only one round away from Savage and now they're playing on the stronger side. And I think the scoreline that we both had envisaged seems to be coming to fruition here.
Exactly. And it's going to be another eco round. We see a smoke and a flashbang on Hades, and let's see, it's going to be towards B. I guess he's going to smoke on the end of the balcony or on the side, and the bomb is just going to run down and try to get the bomb plant. So this time they probably have a better chance, is the word I'm looking for. Yeah, this smoke is going to go to the side, the middle of the side, and try and look out for the bomb plant. He's just going to YOLO down to the side, going to run around, jump around like a rabbit, and try to get this bomb plant.
They've actually thrown both smokes into the site, so they have to plant the bomb really, really fast. Tarek is going to get two kills. He's going to get third with the help of his Molotov. Make it four, as Tarek completely destroys the terrorist side over towards the B site. They were unable even to push into the site. Florence is going to do some little clever play and move towards the A site. Hazed is in a good position to shut them down, though.
Only one who is like questioning the decision of going through the smoke in that situation? Why not just wait the 10 seconds and push him when the smoke is not there anymore?
Well, because they were relying on their own smoke, they wanted to plant the bomb through the smokes perhaps, or they wanted to take advantage
of
the
smoke. Yeah, but why not just wait with throwing their own smoke? They're not in a rush.
Because they threw them before the smoke came down from Tarek.
Okay, then it's either good play by Tarek or just a bit weird play by them. I just think that they should use the time, because also as a terrorist in that situation, if you wait the time out, you're going to force the CTs to use grenades, and those grenades that they use in that round, they need to rebuy the next round. So that's automatically free damage gained on their economy.
Yeah, on the economic level. MouseSpaz with the early kill on Cud.
Yeah, a nice push by the CTs, and he's actually going to get away due to that smoke in the middle. So great push, and he's going to fall back, and here comes the instant flash to connector. Are they going to be able to do the revenge here?
Drops down over towards CPL. CT forces his way back to rotate. Haze throws down that Molotov on towards connector. There's going to be a boost towards CPL.
But they're expecting this.
Just right there and waiting. Nice movement by Tarik as well. Gets the information from Valens. Does not want to be side, comes in to support. Valens will be shot down, but he does take down JDM at the last moment. And now Glorin is the remaining player coming in from the feet at spawn. He will not be able to do anything. MouseSpaz 4-0, as there'll be 10 to 9, one round ahead of Savage. And Savage are looking very, very lackluster on the T side of this map.
Exactly. So MouseSpaz looking really strong. Once again, it's going to be an eco round for Savage. So out of these five rounds, which is going to be played after this one, they had an eco in three of them. Actually only having a decent chance in two of them, because the fifth round, where they have the same equipment as the CTs, and then the first weapon round. So it's quite a disaster, because they're not getting these bomb plants.
Nope. They're really not being successful on any point at the moment. That smoke renewed over T-Ramp, but Hades, get a kill on Hayes. JDM though, from jungle, getting one frag, two frags, three frags, landing those AWP shots with clinical precision. Butler will finish off the jump with a double. As MouseSpaz make it 5-10-0. Now 11-9, Savage, they have a full buy here. If they're unable to start building up momentum on the T side, it's going to be Mirage for MouseSpaz. And it's a pattern that's really appearing that, to be honest, the main difference between both teams in this game and the game before is a stronger T side from the stronger team.
With the initiation coming in from the CTs, trying to go for the mid control here. They're going to headshot the first guy, and they're going to get the second map control gained by the CTs. It's going to be a triple kill. It's going to be four kills by the CT side.
Wow.
A pure massacre here coming in by the nice initiations of the CTs. Not just sitting back and playing it in a stereotypical way, waiting for the terrorists, but they're actually going to take initiative themselves to destroy the plan of the terrorists.
We see a lot of mid pushes from CTs in the European scene, and I think MouseSpaz is learning a lot from the European scene as well. They're playing quite strategy-based CS at the moment. They have plays, even on the CT side, they do have plays. They don't just hold static positions and expect to just land their shots. Sometimes they go for dynamic pushes towards mid. Sometimes they push towards apartments there. You see Tarik getting that information. And map control and information is very, very important in CS, and especially on the CT side. When you get that information and map control and you are ready for the T's who are pushing a site, then it should be easy taking out, especially when you have superior aim. Here, the push in towards the A site. A lot of nades and flashes going through. That forces the CT's to be behind the smoke, but Hayes pops over, steals a kill, and is still alive at 15 HP. FNS here for support with the flash, but oh, they're just going to spray right through the smoke, and actually, he will get a kill on Hades.
Yeah, VTX setup here by the CTs is very strong. It's 5-on-2 situation.
The afterplant positions by the terrorists have been absolutely disastrous. They were unable to stop the retake coming in from the CTs. I mean, they gave them A-site, they went behind the smokes, and they simply just retook it from them with quite ease. But three frags from the Savage players. Relics with two, Lawrence with one.
Yeah. The thing is, when you play a retake setup as a CT in that situation, the best thing which can happen is the same thing which happened for Haste. You get a kill and you hide, and another guy get a kill and they hide, and suddenly you're in a 5-on-3, and the turret is out of smokes because they used all of the smoke grenades and getting onto the bomb site without even the CTs contesting it, so...
Seven rounds in a row.
Yeah.
It's a really, really dominating performance, and it means the score is 13-9 right now. MouseSpaz just needs three rounds to win Mirage and get their first point in this best of three. Again, they go towards the A site. This time they're not going to throw those smokes. In fact, those smokes are in the site, actually, the CT smokes. One smoke from the T-Zone connector. Bomb planted. 4-on-3. Now we see better afterplant positions from the terrorists, but Tarik will curl around that smoke. He'll get a frag, will be flashed by his teammates, sadly. Card's gonna pop out, he gets one frag, JDM takes him down, not fast enough, and FNS will make short work of Relics, and they will get the bomb defusers. They do have a kit. MouseSpaz, 8-0. Tarik, 13 kills to 2 deaths this half. I don't know what his score was in the first half, but it was definitely good as well.
Yeah.
So very, very, very dominating performance from MouseSpaz. And there's not much I can say for Savage, but Cadian, please, please tell me, what are they doing wrong? What can they do better on the T side?
They pretty much tried everything so far. I think they need to go for the more slow play, which is to simply just wait out the smoke from the CTs and then maybe go for delayed mid control or something. Because right now they're trying to force everything in such a fast pace that they can't even control anything themselves. They're gonna get countered by everything the CGs do. But this time they're gonna get a nice entry though, but I would still like to see them wait a bit. CGs with a bit of aggression here in this situation. Terry going for an unnecessary peek onto short, and it's gonna be an open B bump side.
They smell fresh blood, you know, they see the victory very soon. They're on 14 rounds right now, so MouseSpaz perhaps being a bit too impatient on this map. And that will cost them this round. FNS gets one frag on Cud, but it should be an easy round for the Savage side. Their first round on the T side, it will make the score 14-10. Cutler,
yeah, he's
doing
just
a bit more damage though.
He's fine his job now, it's just trying to make damage. But Glarens with this very nice AK headshot, and he's actually impressed me quite a bit because he's aiming very, very good.
8-1 on the second half.
Very good.
Headshot counters on 63. What do you think the percentage is on? Because I can't remember the amount of frags that we got the first half.
It depends. Is this for the only this half? It's only this half, so it's actually
It should be both.
Both? Okay, it's both.
It's both.
Yeah, yes. Okay. Then it's a bit below. Nah, actually, I think
it would be like 100%. 85.
Yeah. By the last time.
It's quite low, actually.
It was 85 last time.
Hades and Aiden, then finished off by JDM. Molotov comes down on Palace as well. The MouseSpaz side are playing a very good CT side. Very nice and textbook. They're throwing the nades at the right time. They're throwing the Molotov at the right time. They're holding the right position. They're being aggressive at the right moment. And they're landing the shot as Aiden gets a quick double kill there. Glorins will return the favor with two from Palace. But he's on his own. It's 1-on-3. He's against FNS, Tarik, and Cutler. FNS will be the man to put the nail on the coffin. It's 15-10.
Yeah.
MouseSpaz now on match point. They just need one more round and they'll get the first map from Savage after a pretty good CT side. And this is almost exactly the same as what we saw in the first game, except in the first game, they didn't get one round on the T side.
And just to make everything totally sure, it's me winning the bet if MouseSpaz wins this round. And JDM with a nice entry kill.
Yes, it is. You will have won it quite a lot because they would have only gotten 10 rounds, and I said they'd get 13, but JDM will get one frag on Nexa. It seems like it's the end of the road for this map, as MouseSpaz will put the nail on the coffin, make it 16-10.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy for
Cadian,
the CT side,
Cadian, Cadian with the
big smile.
Sick predictions, big smile, obviously, because he got this prediction right. But honestly, to be honest, I said it. I thought the same as him, 16-12, but I only said 16-13 to be different. Should have said 16-11, but gave a bit more, too much hope from Savage. But a pretty lackluster T side from the Savage side, and it's a pattern that's reoccurring, as I was mentioning earlier. And what is the kind of medicine for this ailment, do you think?
I think they should just have played a bit slower. The thing is, when the counter-terrorists play a retake set of an A, as they did in the majority of the rounds, what you need to do is, instead of initiate your A push in the beginning of the round, you just spread out and remain map controlled. One guy B apps, one guy underground, one guy holding passive top mid, one guy A slope, and one guy A palace.
Yep.
And when they hold for a minute or so, the CTs is automatically going to use some of the grenades. Those grenades which they use is going to be grenades that they won't have for the retake. So after that minute, you're going to rotate back, make sure that the CTs didn't push. In case they push for information, you just need to punish them. You rotate back, and when you rotate back, you're going to go for your execute, and you're going to have a way bigger chance of actually winning the after plan situation. So that is one option. And the other one is just to try and go for more different set of strategies. If you watch some of the earlier games in Mirage by, for example, LDLC or Fnatic, instead of smoking off CT and on top of the Tetris boxes and so on, they do this long smoke wall where they just charge towards either jungle or CT, which means that they're going to get a new control of the map in the afterplan situation, which is going to give them a high chance of winning it compared to always planting the bomb and falling
staying
back.
Yeah, of course. So, that was an interesting first map, Mirage. The second map will be Nuke. But before then, we'll have a quick short break. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.